question is, what is the drug donut hole?
Ah, the donut hole. We hear this question a lot. The donut hole refers to the coverage gap in your Part D or prescription drug coverage. This amount is set by the federal government each year and is reducing a bit every year. The coverage gap is sometimes called the donut hole because after you have spent $3,700 in drug costs, you enter the hole, where your health plan doesn't help pay for your drugs and you have to pay for them out of your pocket. But let's be honest, a picture of a pastry doesn't really describe the issue. Instead, I'm going to use three water bottles to help explain the gap. This first water bottle represents what you pay toward your drugs. This includes your Part D deductible, co-pays, and co-insurance. The second water bottle represents what your health plan pays toward the cost of your drugs. The middle bottle represents the joint total cost both you and your plan pay toward your drugs. Every time you have a co-pay or co-insurance on a prescription, you're adding that amount into the middle bottle. At the same time, your health plan pays their share of the costs of your prescriptions. Each party keeps paying in until the joint cost of what you and your health plan have paid for your drugs reaches $3,700. If your costs have reached this amount, you enter the coverage gap. Now, it's important to know that not all Medicare Part D members will reach the coverage gap, and other times members might reach it quickly. It all depends on the cost and frequency of your prescription drug needs. If you reach the coverage gap, you are responsible for paying for your drugs. Your health plan coverage takes a back seat. While that may seem daunting, there is some relief. In 2017, members who are in the coverage gap will pay no more than 40% of the plan's cost for covered brand name drugs and will only pay 51% of the cost for generic drugs. To help you get out of the coverage gap faster, Medicare lets you add not just the 40% that you paid out of pocket for that name brand drug, but 90% of the cost to the middle bottle. However, this rule does not apply to generic drugs. For 2017, you will stay in the coverage gap until your total yearly costs have reached $4,950. After that, you enter the catastrophic phase, where your plan takes over and pays nearly the full amount for all your prescriptions. You will only be responsible for a co-insurance of 5% of the approved cost of the drug, or a copay of $3.30 for generics or $8.25 for all other drugs, whichever is greater. Regardless of which phase you are in, you will need to continue paying your monthly Part D premium. It's important to know if you are approaching the coverage gap so that you can be prepared. You can track your prescription drug costs by hand, or you can create an account on our member portal at bcbsm.com/Medicare. Blue Cross will also send you a letter in the mail if you are approaching the coverage gap to ensure you are aware of the changes to your coverage. I hope that you now have a better understanding of the Part D coverage gap. You can find this timely tip and all the others on bcbsm.com. And thank you from Blue Cross.